Okay, so this is my first check-in. I am on page 46. Here I am so far. I am really loving this book so far. I want to keep reading it. The chapters are short, and I really like the atmosphere and setting. So if you don't know what this book is about, I think I will talk about it probably at the beginning of this video, or and probably at the end. But anyways, the main character, Shay, I believe it's pronounced, she is a receptionist, and she is obsessed with true crime, and she has her own blog. And there's other main character named Beth, and she was accused of murder years ago. And so Shay sees Beth one day at work, and she asks for an interview, and she agrees, but also gives a little information about like these murders that she was accused of, and her parents were also murdered. And it, so far it's like seems like there's like certain things in the book that's written, and it seems like that she's guilty, you know. She's like, oh, I deserve this, or I deserve that. And but I want, my theory is that I feel, I also want to say that the reason why she was accused is because a witness says that he saw a woman there that looks like her, resembles her, red hair and a trench coat and this black car, and she has all those things. But what I think happened is that she was there, and that's why she feels guilty, probably because she didn't call the cops. But I don't think she was the murderer. I think maybe she was driving and she saw this man that was murdered and shot. She saw that, but because she she's dealing with these things, like her parents were murdered, I feel like she can't deal with murder, she can't handle it. So I think she left the scene, and that's when the witness was there and he saw that. So it makes it look like she was a murderer, but yeah, I think maybe she didn't do it and she was just there. But the reason why she feels guilty is because she didn't call the cops or anything. I think just because she didn't want to deal with that, like death all over again. There also is a supernatural, a little hint of supernatural in this book. But I think I remember seeing or hearing some reviews, and people were saying that there wasn't like ghosts or anything like that, or they were confused if there was or not. But so far I'm thinking it seems like there is, like it seems like there's ghosts, but it's not. I believe it's her memories, like, and it's more like her memories are haunting her, and it's not like this stuff is actually happening like while she's an adult. Just to like clarify, is this woman, she's I think like 60 or 70 years old right now. She's an old woman, and she lives in the mansion still where she grew up in, where her parents died. And she like locks the door every night, and she hears like these voices. She hears her mom screaming, she hears people or somebody trying to open all the doors and get in. And what I think is, it's not ghosts, but I think it's a memory from that night of when her dad was killed, maybe. But yeah, I think it's more memories and it's not actually a ghost. But that's my theory so far. Hi, I'm back for another update. I'm more than halfways. I just need like 104 pages left. My bunny is like pushing my foot. She probably wants something, but anyways. I just need like 100 pages left, and about when I was exactly like halfway, there was a twist, and I didn't see that coming, so that is great. And I did like the twist, like that was pretty cool. What else? Was there something like, you know, super crazy or anything like that? But because there's still like a good chunk left in the book, I'm hoping that there's going to be more information or another twist or something, because with the information that was given at the middle of the story, that pretty much like with that information, you get that idea of like the mystery, like the answers to everything. So yeah, I hope like, you know, that there's more like another twist, like I said, because then otherwise, you know, the 100 pages is probably, you know, kind of, or it would be unnecessary. But so far, I'm really liking it. Hi, I'm doing a quick announcement. I am only 4 pages away. I am on the last chapter. I want to say that I do not want to finish this book. I'm like, because I really like it. I'm loving it. So I don't want it to end. I wish there was more. So yeah, I'm really, really liking it. Depending how it ends right now, that's going to determine if I'm going to love this book or just like it a lot. I'm hoping to love it. I want it to be a 5-star. So, you know, just my final reaction will determine that. So let's hope. You coming home time. Okay, welcome back. I am done with this book. I liked it a lot. I'm a little disappointed though, because I wanted this so much to be a 5-star. Like I said in my vlog and my last clip, I believe. But I wanted it so much to be a 5-star, and it could have been if it just ended like good, but it didn't. Like, the author went more for a kind of like dramatic ending. I don't want to say what it is, you know, obviously because it's the ending and I'll like spoil it, but yeah, she just went for a more dramatic, I kind of want to say poetic even, like, just like, I don't know, she just went a certain direction with ending this book, and I just didn't like it. Like, I didn't care for it. You know, because it was dramatic, I feel. But yeah, if it just ended, differently, this definitely would have been a 5-star for me, because like the whole time I loved this book. Like, I don't have any complaints. Like, I think just like one tiny little thing, but that's pretty much it. Like, I did not dislike this book at all in the slightest. So yeah, that's like the only thing, like I said, because I was liking it so much, it was very disappointing that it wasn't 5-stars. And so, to talk about what I liked about it, the chapters, well, it's hard to say because obviously it's like, okay, it's what I like, but just to talk about like how the book was like written, for example, the chapters were really short. It is going between two POVs. It's going between Beth and Shay. It's also, the story is also going back and forth between the past and present. And with the past, you kind of get more information into Beth's life. So you see not only when she was convicted of murder and like during that time, but even far back when she was a child, and you could like see how she was with her family and everything. So that was like really cool that the author added that touch. Another really, really fun thing that I liked is that there is parts of this book that were kind of like conversations through like the trial and also through a podcast. So it just has like little like back and forth conversations, and I thought that was really fun. I really liked that. I also really liked the characters. Everyone was different. They're, in my opinion, they weren't like cliche or anything, or even if they were, I just didn't notice, and because they were so like entertaining and I just really enjoyed them. Even Beth, like, she was rude and she was mean, but I think it's kind of what made her character kind of like funny in a way, like not humorous funny, but it's like, oh, you know, like she has an attitude. So I even liked Beth. I also really, really loved the atmosphere and the setting of the story. It takes place in Oregon, so like the whole, you know, setting is like cold and rainy and cloudy and gray. And the mansion, I loved the idea of like the mansion and how it's like on top of a hill, and like the hill like is at the edge of the ocean. Like, I don't know, I just really liked that whole idea. There was a twist in the middle of the book. I said that in my blog. But yeah, there was a twist, and that I didn't see coming. And in my vlog, I mentioned how like there were still 100 pages left, and I wonder how it's going to end, because it's like, okay, we found out the twist, so that's pretty much, we could kind of like piece together the truth of everything that happened. So there was not another twist, but even though there wasn't, it was a good ending. Like the last 100 pages, it was a good like flow, and everything was like in good timing. Nothing was like rushed or left out. And at the end of the book, you started seeing, by that time, like by the time you found out the twist, from that point then on, it's like you're just in the past for a bit, and you're getting more details of Beth's past, and also with this twist. So it's really cool. So it's kind of like you were taken back in time for a while, and then but it's also, there was parts like it did go back in the future a little bit. I really liked that there was character development with the one of the main characters, Shay. Like that was nice. What else? Oh yeah, but yeah, like I was saying with the last part of the book, even though there was another twist or anything like that, it was like everything was very like action-packed and kind of like suspenseful, I would say. So it like made up for that, and it's really good. I really enjoyed that. The last 100 pages, there are also in that like end part of the book, there's kind of like description of scenes, kind of, I don't, not necessarily the murder scenes, but it kind of, like, I guess, like, kind of, not, like, super detailed or anything, like, gory, but, when it did talk about those scenes of the murders and everything, I liked that, because it was, like, a good amount of detail where you could picture everything. Like, you could picture the scene, you could picture what's going on. So that was really good. Okay, so the only thing that, aside from the ending, and it not being five stars, the only thing that I didn't like about this book is that I can't say, because I think that's part of the twist. So I can't say, but there's just something I don't like, because a character doesn't seem their age. Yeah, that's all I could say, really. It just has to do with like their age and it just not seeming like possible, kind of. I also want to say, for trigger warnings, that and that's the thing, I try to be careful, it's sexual assault, but specifically with that word that starts with R, I try to be careful, just because I don't know if that word would trigger, just that word by itself would trigger somebody. So but I want to say that word is mentioned in this book like twice, I think. So sexual assault is a trigger warning for this book, but also pedophilia. It's not in details or anything, but it just mentions how, you know, somebody did something to a little girl and then killed her. So no detail, like I said, but it's just that, just like simple as that, that sentence is in this book. So I just want to give a warning for that. Now I'm gonna go into spoilers. Okay, so now for spoilers. What I couldn't mention just a bit ago was that about Lily, how when she was younger, when the book was talking about the past, and when she was younger, and how she didn't like Beth's dad, like she just, like, I don't know, like, and how, like, she would talk to Beth like about her dad, you know. I just feel like, because she was like 10 years old, I think, like at the time, like she was like 10, and she's like, don't worry, we don't need him. I mean, I could probably understand that quote, but there were just other things where she was just like, I don't know. I just thought it's like, how can a little girl understand that, you know, like, okay, this is my, no, not my half dad. This is like my, I don't know, the man that my mother married and had a kid with, you know, like I know kids are smart. I know they're smart, but I just understand how she could kind of have like grasped that at her age and have so much like hatred towards this man. And for her to, like, the way she talked to Beth, like I said, when she was younger, I just thought that was kind of like, I don't really see that being realistic. So that's the only, like, complaint I have. Also had a few questions. One is about Lily. Like, when she showed up at the mansion that first time, you know, with her footsteps, like, in the grass and her writing on the window, like, all that stuff. And she told Beth, like, oh, yeah, like, I knew about this place. But I'm like curious on how she knew, because it didn't specify, I don't think. But yeah, I'm curious, like, how does she know about her mom? How does she know about this mansion? How does she know that her mom was rich, you know? And the only thing that I could think or guess is that her foster parents told her. So that's pretty much it. But yeah, I just think that part is kind of, you know, again, like a little bit unrealistic. Because I feel like, you know, people who are in the foster system, they don't, like, know about their parents, at least until they're, like, older. Like, probably, like, 16, maybe, or 15. Like, once they're older, I think then they'll have questions and start looking for their parents. But this, Lily was, like, a little girl. She was, like, probably 8 or something when she first showed up. So, it's like, okay, how did you know this? Another question that I did not answer, because, like, and it was like questions in the book, like she kept asking, why did Beth choose me, you know, why did she choose me to interview her? And I wish that question was answered, because I also was curious about that, you know. Like, yeah, I'm curious to why Beth chose her specifically. Or maybe it wasn't because it was her, maybe it was just because her time was like coming up, you know, because she was sick and all. So maybe she just like agreed to whoever just asked her next. So that was probably the reason. So what else? And then, yeah, I was kind of, so, you know, with all that paranormal stuff, like, I guess it would be considered like not really spirits, but more like poltergeist, right? Because like Lily was able to hurt Shay. And I thought that was maybe like all imagination. Like Lily was trying to show her, like, oh, look what happened to me, kind of thing. But yeah, like, she actually, that was all real. She actually hurt Shay. And then she was also like seen, though, like the little boy, I think his name was Toby, like he seen her. So yeah, I don't know, that's kind of like the only thing. And then, I mean, I guess Lily was a bad person, what do you expect? Because, you know, Beth said like, oh yeah, you know, she likes you. Like, Beth was telling Shay that Lily likes her enough to like tell her the truth or show her the truth. But it's like, you know, that's probably, take that with a grain of salt, because she was a murderer and she killed people for no reason. But yeah, she tried killing Shay for no reason, so that whole thing happened. And then the ending, like I said, I didn't like that it ended that way. I liked that it was like it ended on the mansion, I guess, like it was saying, like, you know, people, like, it was showing that people moved on from, like, the, I don't want to say rumors, but, you know, like all that story about Beth and her being like the lady killer or whatever, like the community moved on and then people moved into that mansion and they're living their own lives, like, and it was showing this like picture perfect family kind of in that mansion. And then it like ends with like, oh, but there's like still ghosts there, you know, like spirits still live there. And I'm assuming it's Lily and Beth that are still there. Which would have been cool, like, if it, like, oh yeah, that they're still, their spirits are still here, they didn't move on, they didn't get closure, you know. So like, that's cool, but maybe if it was just executed differently. But like the last line, like, I'm gonna read it right now, but it says, and that night while they slept, two strange lights burned in the darkness. I just didn't like that. I didn't like that part. So I was like disappointing. I was like, God damn it. But other than that, I really liked the book. So that is my vlog on The Book of Cold Cases by Simone St. James and my review. Now I'm gonna go ahead and do an unboxing. Okay, here is my box. This is for June. This is June's pick. And there was two books that I was, not deciding on. There's two books that I wanted, but I just kind of, I've been like getting multiple books like these past couple months. Like I've been getting like two books instead of one, or one month I got three. And so it's kind of like a little too much, because my backlist was starting to get bigger or whatever. So I was like, okay, let me just get one so I could catch up. And so I did catch up. I just have one book from like the past month, the month that I got three books. I have one of those books. No, it was a different month. I think it was last month. Yeah, it was last month. But anyways, I have The Hacienda, and then I have this one that just came in. So I just have two books, so it's not that bad. Here is the box, and I decided on this one. I got a thriller. The other one was a thriller too. Let's see. Here is what the bookmark says. Book of the month. Yeah, so I got Things We Do in the Dark. Here's what the inside looks like, the colors. I can't remember what this one was about. The other one that I wanted was, I think, the Lies I've Told or something like that. And it's about this, I think it's about a woman. I don't think they're sisters, but it's about these two women. And one of them kind of has like multiple identities. And then the other woman kind of like is going to get revenge or something on her. Something like that. But this one, let me go ahead and read to you what it's about. It says, when Paris, I don't know how to read that. When Paris Peralta is arrested in her own bathroom, covered in blood, holding a straight razor, her celebrity husband dead in the bathtub behind her, she knows she'll be charged with murder. But as bad as this looks, that's not what worries her the most. With the unwanted media attention now surrounding her, it's only a matter of time before someone from her long-hidden past recognizes her and destroys the new life she's worked so hard to build, along with any chance of a future. 25 years earlier, Ruby Reyes, known as the Ice Queen, was convicted of a similar murder in a trial that was a media sensation and riveted the nation. Reyes knows who Paris really is, and when Reyes is unexpectedly granted an early release from prison, she threatens to expose all of Paris's secrets. Left with no other choice, Paris must finally, once and for all, confront the dark past she thought she had escaped. Because the only thing worse than a murder charge is the dark personal history that Paris will do anything to keep hidden. So, I'm excited for this one, but I'm not gonna read it just yet. I think I'm gonna start on The Hacienda first, and then start this one. Thank you again for watching my reading vlog and my review. I'll see you guys next time.